وعليكم السلام. اي واضح يا دكتور.
حياكم الله جميعا، كل عام وانتم بخير. معكم عبد الرحمن السديس، اي ان تي ريزيدنت برنس سلطان ميليتري ميديكال سيتي ار 3. بالبدايه حاب اشكر المنظمين على الانترودكشن فور ريزيدنسي بروجرامز، وان شاء الله باذن الله انكم راح تستفيدون ايا كان التخصص، ادخلوا وشوفوا ايش اللي يفيدكم فيه، لانه بعض الاشياء ممكن تغيب عنكم وتستفيدوا اذا شفتوا البرزنتيشنز. راح اتكلم اليوم عن الاي ان تي سب سبيشاليتي. بدايه بالنسبه للاي ان تي الاز باك جراوند، اتس ا ميديكال اند سيرجيكال سبيشاليتي، يعني موستلي اتس سيرجيكال، يعني يو ويل هاف لايك 2 او ارز بير ويك and most of the cases you will deal with them as surgical wise, and some of the patient doesn't need surgery, you will treat them as a medical with medications. It's a 5-year program. I will explain it later in the slides. You will have a lot of different subspecialties after the ENT. It's about 6 subspecialties. I will go over them regarding the lifestyle considerations, practice options. يعني during residency years you will not depend or you will not judge on any speciality. يعني most of the subspecialities are heavy during residency. طبعا في اختلاف بين التخصصات، بس برضو it's not your goal. يعني your goal is after residency. يعني this is your main job after residency. Most of the residency subspecialities you will have heavy work and lifestyle will be horrible, so don't depend on it. And regarding the practice options, while you are a resident, you only can practice in governmental hospitals because you don't have the certificate of ENT of any other specialty to work in a private. Regarding dealing with all age groups, ENT deals with newborns, pediatric, adolescent, adults, and elderly, all the age groups. Regarding the outcome and income, يعني I would say the ENT one of the best specialties. You will see an outcome of the patient immediately post-op. يعني let's say a patient with nasal obstruction, you examine the patient, patient has nasal deviated nasal septum, post-septoplasty he will benefit. يعني he will nasal obstruction will resolve immediately post-op. Patient will has like recurrent tonsillitis, you will remove the tonsils, no more recurrent tonsillitis, immediately post-op. Patient has tympanic membrane perforation, you will fix it, and post-op patient immediately will hear well, and his hearing will improve. So the outcome is fast. And also there is some surgeries, type of surgeries in ENT, the outcome needs time. And there is other specialties, usually the outcome will take long time, without naming any specialty. Regarding the income, as a resident and as a governmental employee, they all the same. يعني a resident حق الفاميلي زي a resident حق الجي اس زي الاي ان تي، كلهم the same while in the same hospital. Some of the hospitals يختلفون طبعا اختلافات بسيطه. حتى الاستشاري وحتى الاخصائي نفس المستشفى نفس الراتب، سواء باختلاف التخصصات طبعا، هم يشوفون على المرتبة، ما له دخل التخصص. الاختلاف يكون بالبرايفت طبعا. As you know, surgical specialties better income regarding the private more than medical subspecialties. There is some medical, they have a good income, but most يعني أتكلم generally, surgical is better. Regarding the ENT and the OR, يعني most of our surgeries will take short OR time. يعني like if I have septoplasty, it will take like 1 hour. Adenotonsillectomy, it will take 30 minutes. Tympanoplasty, it will take like 1 hour. So for me, I don't like to spend too much time on one case. يعني there is some specialties, it will take long time for one case. Also with us, يعني head and neck, like if you have laryngeal cancer, you have to take the whole larynx. It will take like 6 hours. So, and also skull-based subspecialties, like patient have CSF leak, So you will repair it. It will take long time. So most of our surgeries are short OR time, except head and neck and skull-based subspecialties in ENT. Regarding areas of patient care, you will work in the clinic. You will work as inpatient doing rounds. You will work in special areas like in surgery, like intra-op in the theater, and in the ER while you are on call. Regarding the outpatient clinic, يعني the usual and average, you will have two clinics or 2 days per week in the clinic. The inpatient you will do, if you have inpatient, سواء كان post-op or admission من الأنكول, you will do rounds every day for that patient. Like if you have surgery, it will start earlier, so you have to come earlier than the surgery. And most of the medical specialties, you can do the round like at 8, the beginning, يعني في بداية الدوام ما عندك إشكالية, but تلاحظون ممكن surgical specialties, they come earlier to see those patients اللي يسوون عليهم الراوند, then go to the theater or going to the clinic. So you have to do the round earlier. Special areas of surgery, as I mentioned, you will have like 2 ORs per week, يعني بالaverage, sometimes 1 OR. Like you will have OR in the main theaters that patient needs admission, like patient has comorbidities, you need to admit before, or patient as a day case, like patient is medically free but has recurrent tonsillitis, so you can do it as a day case. Patient will come in the morning, you will do the surgery, patient will be discharged afternoon. Regarding the ER, you will face the ER cases in the on-calls, mostly, as we call the ER cases as hot cases, and you have to see the cases urgently. Otherwise, no need for the patient to come to the ER. In the clinic, it's a cold cases, and a patient can wait. Patient will present to you with nasal obstruction for 2 months. So patients can wait and you can diagnose them without any urgency. Regarding the ER, you have to see the patient immediately and treat them accordingly. And you will have in the ER, we have like in the on calls, you will see airway cases. Patient comes with a stridor, shortness of breath. You have to do scope. Sometimes we have to push the patient to OR to do tracheostomy for the patient because they cannot breathe. You will deal with bleeding. It's urgent, like epistaxis, nasal bleeding or oral bleeding. So you will deal with the whole, يعني ear pathology, throat pathology, from the throat down to the larynx. This is your area, and including the whole neck. So it's wide area to cover in ENT. It's not like ear, nose, throat. This is the old name. Now it's ear, nose, throat, and head and neck oncology or surgery, including the whole airway. Regarding the ENT surgery subtypes, يعني intra-op, you will face you will deal with the patient according to his pathology. So laparoscopic, you will deal with patient coming with chronic sinusitis. You have to clean the sinus, doing functional endoscopic sinus surgery. You will do it as a laparoscopic approach, as you see here in the left. Microscopic, we usually do them for the ear pathologies, like you will deal with the tympanic membrane, you will deal with the inner ear, you will do cochlear implant, you will do mastoidectomy, all with microscope. Gross, usually with the head and neck procedures, like head and neck oncology, laryngeal cancer, hypopharyngeal cancer, oral cancer, skull-based cancers, mostly gross, and you have to open and start the surgery. Okay, moving to which center should I choose? يعني حطيت هذه الأشياء بالأهمية الانفايرمنت, I made the text bigger. يعني for me it's the most important for me. الانفايرمنت between the residents, between the resident and consultant, resident and subspecialty and the specialist, resident and nurses. يعني how to know about the environment in the hospital, you have to take electives there. And you will have like 2 electives or 3 in the internship. So you will face different hospitals and advise you not to take 2 electives in the same hospital. There is no point to take 2 electives or 2 months in the same hospital. try different hospitals and check for the environment. How are the residents together and how is the environment overall? يعني this what makes you successful at the end. Regarding the cutting exposure, this is important for any surgical specialty. يعني if you want to choose ENT, you will choose it because you love OR. Any surgical specialty, you have to love the OR environment and cutting and doing surgery for the patient. So when you want to taking elective for any center in Kingdom Saudi Arabia, you will ask about how is the cutting exposure? How many cases I will face per week? How many like adenotonsils? How many septoblasts? How many tympanoplasty? How many head and neck surgeries I will do? So this is the most important. Regarding the teaching, centers, they are different teaching. And some of them are academic, like King Abdulaziz, Mustashfa Malik Abdulaziz Al-Jami'i. They are academic consultants there. So they are more willing to teach than other hospitals. But for me, I don't consider it as, I will not put it as a high standard for me regarding the teaching, because everyone can teach himself. You have videos in the YouTube, you can find any surgery, any ENT surgery you want, just type it. You will have all the books you need, you will have all the information, just read. So teaching, sometimes it's good for you as the consultant can guide you what to learn. But regarding the teaching, you will not depend upon choosing the specialty or the center and the teaching نفسه. Regarding the on-calls, it's different from hospital to hospital, from center to center. يعني regarding the Prince Sultan Military Medical City, يعني I will consider them moderate to heavy on-calls. Taking number of on-calls depends على a number of residents, junior residents. يعني at R1, usually it's outside ENT. You will deal with other specialties. I will label them later. And from R2, you will start as ENT. In the R2 and R3, you will be first on call. Our on calls usually, and most of Kingdom Saudi Arabia for ENT, it is 24 hours on call. Some of the specialties, they took now currently on calls of 12 hours, but because it's heavy on calls for them, like pediatric and medicine. So for me, and it's hospital on call, and I told you it depends on the hospital itself. Any King Fahad Medical City, I think it's home on call. It's not heavy as Prince Sultan. And Haras, it's considered as heavy. So it depends on the hospital, and you will ask the residents there, and you will take on calls with them, and you will know how is the on-calls going there. And regarding the on-calls, I told you what cases you will see, the hot cases, the airway and the bleeding and the deep neck space infections, like peritonsillar abscess, like retropharyngeal abscess, that you have to admit the patient either to start IV antibiotics or to push the patient to the OR. Regarding clinic load, yani for me, I don't prefer the clinic to be loaded with a lot of patients, and you will have less teaching from the consultants. Sometimes if there is shortage of residents, you will go to admission clinic and you will just do the admission for elective surgical cases. So moderate, يعني أفضل الوسطية بموضوع الكلينكس. ما تكون light مرة وما تكون heavy مرة. Light مرة you will not benefit, and heavy مرة you will not benefit. And always it's better for the resident, as a junior resident, to stay with the consultant in the clinic. But sometimes they pull you out to do the admission. Regarding why surgical specialties have less residents than the medical subspecialties, as you know, يعني, because of the OR exposure. And imagine if ENT accepts like 50 residents per year, and each center will take 7 to 8 residents, you will have less exposure in the OR, you will have less cutting, and this thing يعني will not benefit you eventually. You need to cut more. Regarding the subspecialties available, different from each center, like in Prince Sultan Military Medical City, you will have all the six subspecialties. I will talk about them. And other centers have five or four. So it depends on the center. But for me, it's okay to be accepted at any center with a good exposure because you can take an outside rotation. And some of the centers, they made it as like a specialized center and no need for the residents to go out. But you can go out if you ask permission from the program director. You can take like elective in other hospitals. I will give you an example. Like King Salman Hospital, you will face like junior level cases. Like you'll have a lot of adenotonsil, a lot of septoplasty, a lot of tympanoplasty. But if you need like more of head and neck cases, doing total laryngectomy and doing flaps for the patient reconstruction, you need to go to higher center like King Fahd Medical City or Prince Sultan Military Medical City or King Faisal Special Center. So you can manipulate with your rotations by requesting the program director. Regarding the ENT subspecialties, in case A, we have like otology, rhinology and allergy, head and neck surgery, and laryngology, and pediatric ENT, and airway surgery, and fascioplasty. Regarding the otology, you will deal always with the audiologist. They are the one who do the hearing assessment for the patient, and you will read the results. And depending on the result, you will make your plan with the patient. Allergy, you can take it as a subspecialty with the rhinology. Regarding the head and neck surgery, you will deal with the trach team. They are specialized nurses inside the hospital dealing with the trach patients. Yani, a lot of patients doing like total laryngectomy have to do tracheostomy for the patient. The patient cannot breathe from the upper airway. So most of the time you will deal with the trach team for follow-up with the patient. Regarding laryngology, you will deal with the voice therapist. And sometimes patient comes to you with hoarseness. Sometimes it's benign due to reflux. Sometimes it's malignant due to like vocal cord lesion, maybe benign, maybe malignant. If it's malignant, the laryngologist will refer the case to head and neck surgeon. Regarding the pediatric airway, or pediatric ENT, mostly will deal with the swallowing team. They are specialized people to deal with the swallowing issues. Patient has frequent choking due to like maybe laryngomalacia. So most of the time we will deal with swallowing team when in pediatric team and fascioplasty, as you know. Regarding how to get accepted in local ENT program, as you know, it depends on three things. The most important is the CMLE grade and comes after the GPA, then lastly the CV. As you know, ENT became highly competitive subspecialty. It's one of the most three competitive subspecialities in Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. So you have to work hard regarding your GPA. And maybe now you are in the last year, so you cannot change much in your GPA. You can study hard for the CMLE and focus on question banks. And regarding CV, make research focused on ENT. So taking electives and recommendations, you have to like, when you come to the interview, you have to take like one or two electives in ENT because they will ask you, what center have you been rotating in? How was the exposure? What surgeries have you seen? How do you deal with blah, blah, any cases they mentioned to you? And recommendation letters from the consultant that you have been working with. Regarding working on research focused on ENT, any, no need to write a research in the CV. It's published. You can write research that you just started and you will write next to it under a process of publication. بس خبروهم يعني انكم انتم you are willing to do a research related to ENT regarding score as high as possible in Similian CV, as I mentioned to you. Take a service. This depends upon you. If you love the ENT after exposure and internship, you can wait for 1 year, then take a service, then apply again for the program. And some of you will ask, will I be accepted if I am a service, or they will accept fresh graduates? There is no difference between them. If you have a better CV than a fresh graduate, even if you are a service, they will take you. Regarding the local programs in our country, R1, as I told you, it's a surgical foundation training. You will rotate in GS 2 months, in the ICU 2 months, anesthesia and plastic surgery, neurosurgery, pediatric surgery, thoracic surgery, and ER. This will take like a whole year and 1 month annual leave. The GS, you will learn how to deal with surgical patient, how to stabilize the patient, how to deal with the surgical wounds, how you will deal with the pre-op planning for the patient, making the patient in IV fluids and antibiotics and these things. ICU, it's important because you will deal with the ICU patients, because sometimes you will have admitted ENT patient in the ICU. So you have to deal with the patient in the ICU. It's different from the ward patient. Regarding anesthesia, because you are an airway surgeon, so taking elective in anesthesia, it's important. How to do intubation, how to deal with the airway, how to give muscle relaxants, and how to sedate the patient. All these are important for you because you are an airway surgeon. Regarding a plastic surgery, it's important because you will deal with the wounds. They are the best in dealing with the wounds and flaps. So eventually when you are with the head and neck surgeon with reconstruction, he can do flaps without free flaps, even without calling a plastic. So you have to deal with the flap patient in the ward after the surgery. And they will teach you well regarding suturing also. Regarding neurosurgery, because you will deal with skull base. Skull-based surgery, it's related to us, and also neurosurgery. Regarding the pediatric surgery, because you are dealing also with the pediatric age group, so it's important as a surgical-wise. And thoracic surgery, some of our cases extend to the thorax, like I would say thyroid goiter extending to the thorax, thyroid cancer extending to the thorax, so you have to deal with the upper airway also, or upper thorax. Regarding the ER, it's important, as you know, what's the first presentation for any case and how to deal with it. From R2 to R5, it's a pure ENT. In the first 2 years, you will be a junior. As I told you, you will be the first on call in R2 and R3. Usually you will go to the general ENT, and in the most important rotations like pediatric, head and neck, otology, rhinology. Any laryngology, fascioplasty, you will take it later. It's not that important for you as a junior. And that's it for the residency program. You will have a BART exam in R2 and board exam at the end of R5. And every year you will have an exam called the promotion exam. They will see your progress during the years. And my advice, if you will apply to ENT, take the BART exam in R1, in the surgical foundation training. You can take it and study hard for it, because if you start the ENT program, you will be busy and your work will be much heavier, so studying for the exam will be harder. So if you are applying for ENT, take it in R1. This is my advice for you. Regarding Riyadh acceptance ninety in 2022. First matching was 24 candidates matched. In the interviews, they interviewed all and four candidates excluded. For the four candidates excluded, what the options that they have, they can apply next year. Nothing to be done. يعني they can take service, and sometimes taking service as a job and official employee in the hospital with a salary, it's difficult to find. Maybe you can find it in the peripheral cities, but you can take clinical attachment. You can take it like in our hospital, in other hospital in Riyadh, but you will not have a salary. Just to show interest for the program director and other teams in the hospital. Because if you want to apply the next year, they will know you. After the second matching, just the 20 matched candidates matched, final matching. And this is the distribution of the 20 residents in this year. Two went in King Faisal Specialist Hospital, three in Al-Haras, three in التجمع الصحي الأول, هذا اسمه صار جديد. ثلاثة يكونون روتيتور, مدينة الملك فهد الطبية ومستشفى الأمير محمد بن عبد العزيز. This is an example of يعني you will benefit from junior and senior levels. يعني محمد بن عبد العزيز will have a junior cases and King Fahd Medical City will have a senior cases. So this is a good example. And in our hospital, three candidates in King Abdulaziz University Hospital, four candidates, because it's pure ENT hospital. وهذا التجمع الصحي الثاني, مدينة الملك فهد, مدينة الملك سعود الطبية ومستشفى الملك سلمان, three candidates also. And مستشفى قول أمن, two candidates. So total of 20 matched this year. Regarding what to choose, I would say if you got accepted in Riyadh, you will benefit, and you will, your program will be good for you, whatever what the hospital. You, as I mentioned to you, can take outside rotation if you are not يعني, satisfied with your center. Another thing, you will have, as the two duties I mentioned to you, and we have a weekly activity, all the residents in Riyadh will join. It's in the Wednesday afternoon. We'll present a grand round and tutorial. Grand round, junior resident will present a case and senior resident will supervise him and with the consultant. And they will ask the residents in the audience about the case. And the tutorial, a consultant in ENT specialized, he will talk about a subject, like I would say thyroid cancer. So we will have it, you will have it weekly, every Wednesday. You are released from your hospital. This is official release. And you will go to your activity. Regarding the working aspects, the workload, as I mentioned to you, in residency, ENT is heavy, subspecialty, and most of the subspecialties also heavy. And even And I'm sorry to say that, but even the family medicine, it's heavy. They will have rotations in OB-GYN, they will have rotations in medicine, they will have rotations in pediatric. All these subspecialties are heavy. Regarding the oncology and workload after residency, it will be much less for you. Even if you are a consultant, you can take, you can work 3 days a week in the governmental hospital. And you will have one OR day and one clinic day or two clinic day and one day for round. Regarding the on-calls, depends on the hospital. يعني for me, I'm taking 5 to 6 on-calls per month. Each one of them is 24 hours. Sometimes I can sleep, sometimes I cannot. In other hospitals, it's home on-call. And it's less heavier, and other hospitals, it's much heavier than us also. So it depends on the center, actually. يعني for me, ENT, it's a moderate heavy on call compared to other subspecialties. يعني I would say ortho, GS, they are like medicine, they are much heavier than us. and other subspecialties without mentioning them, they are less heavier than us. Regarding the work environment, as I mentioned to you, it's very important for you to deal and be successful in the hospital. يعني if every resident and consultant encourage you, you will be successful. So try to have a good environment. Regarding the types of cases, you will have short cases, you will have long cases, you will have outpatient clinic, you will have inpatient, you will have OR cases, you will have ER cases. So different cases. What's good about ENT or surgical specialty? In your routine, it's different day from other day. And there is some specialties every day they are in the clinic. Some specialties every day they are in like in the ER. For you, you will have like Sunday you will have clinic, Monday you will have OR, Tuesday you will have round for the patients, Wednesday you will have another clinic, and Thursday you will have like an OR. So you will have different routine, and this is good for me and depends on you. Regarding lifestyle at work and personal lifestyle, lifestyle as at work, as I mentioned to you, and personal lifestyle as a resident, I will say it again, it's a moderate, because ENT or any other surgical specialty, you will have to read for the disease itself and read how to approach surgically. And you have two different readings you will read, and it's heavy material to read. And this is one of the disadvantages of the ENT. But if you love it, you will take it easy. Because there is a medical specialties, they will deal with the disease and how to treat it as by medications or any other interventions. But like if you are a surgeon, you have to read exactly what you are doing in the OR, and you have to know the disease itself, the pathophysiology of the disease. Regarding advantages and disadvantages of the specialty, regarding the lifestyle, regarding the workload, as I mentioned, as a consultant, it's a good, one of the good subspecialties. Regarding the income, it's very good in the private. In the governmental, there is no much difference. In the outcome, it's, for me, it's a fast outcome. In most of the surgeries, patients will benefit immediately post-op. And this is good for the physician. You will feel it later. Regarding a variety of cases, you will deal with variety of age groups. You will deal with variety of subspecialties. And you will deal with ear, nose, throat, the whole throat to the larynx. You will deal with the vocal cords, with the voice. You will deal with the pediatric age groups, airway. You will deal with the neck itself, doing neck dissection and removal of the all like metastatic lymph nodes. And you will deal with the nose and sinuses and skull base. So you will have so different cases. Regarding a variety of surgical approaches, as I mentioned before, so you have laparoscopic, microscopic, and gross. Regarding a different routine every day at work, as I mentioned before to you, this is one of the advantages. Regarding the disadvantages, the on-calls, as I mentioned for you, it's heavy and depends on the center you will apply for. Learning material, as I mentioned for you, you have to study for the surgery itself, and you have to study for the material or the disease itself. Number of residents, as I mentioned to you, any surgical specialty, number of residents it's less than the medical specialty due to exposure in the OR. This one is advantage and disadvantage. Advantage that you will work more in the OR, and disadvantage the workload will be more on you. Regarding acceptance and residency, as I told you, it's high competitive. So you have to work hard to be accepted. And there is no harm if you take 1 year service. A lot of them applied for service and accepted in the next year, especially if you love the specialty you are applying for. There is no harm to take a service. regarding acceptance in subspecialty, it's not easy to apply for subspecialty in our country because the seats are limited. But you can apply it outside if you have a sponsor. Like if you will work in periphery, in peripheral city, you can work in that hospital and tell them that I will apply in subspecialty in outside. They will give you a salary and you will go there taking the subspecialty and come back and work with them. So it's much difficult than other subspecialty in taking a subspecialty. Regarding the job availability, if you are a consultant, you have the subspecialty, taking a job, any job availability will be more easier than being a specialist or after directly after the residency program. And this is my talk for today. Thank you all for listening. وهذا الباركود فيه نصائح للسنة الامتياز راح تفيدكم إن شاء الله من بداية من سنة الامتياز كيف تخطط و how to go in the golden months. The golden months to take the elective rotations. Better for you to take in these months. And this is my email and Twitter account if you want to contact for me anytime. And thank you so much. Any questions you have?
Please.